Hey there, welcome. I'm Heather. Thanks for joining me. Today we're going to be talking all about strategies to feed your family healthy foods and not be stressed. I want you guys in this zone, happy plus healthy, and less in this zone, healthy plus stressed. Nobody wants that. So today I'm going to arm you with strategies. Now, I'm a mom of four. I have four little kiddos. They're 2, 4, 6, and 8, which is super fun to say in this year that they're all those ages. So I got a big family to feed, and the last thing that I want is for food to be stressful. So I have learned a lot over the years of being a mom for the past 8 years, and I'm gonna arm you guys with strategies to implement so that you can feed your family healthy foods and it not be stressful, because I do not want that for you. So my tip number one is going to be to focus on whole food, real food. What is real food? I feel like the term real food, whole food, clean eating, all of those just get thrown around, and really I think they mean a lot of the same things. Basically, we're focusing on ingredients. I love to say foods that grew from the ground or they had a mother, and that encompasses a ton of foods. Now, real food can also be pre-made food that if you look at the back of it and the ingredients are things that you could have in your kitchen and you could create this, that's a real food too. It's just made a little easier to help us save some time. My journey of getting to where I am at with whole foods, real foods, has, gosh, that is a whole episode on its own. We'll probably come back to that sometime. But it was not just one day I switched and I started eating, just focusing on real foods. No, it took time. And I want you to know that if it feels like it's taking time for you, that it's okay to honor that and just to allow that time to happen. Okay, so our tip number one was to focus on real foods. Now with those foods, we are going to build balanced plates. And what does a balanced plate look like? So we're gonna focus on four areas. Now, I really wanted to say three, but the fourth one is really important. So we're gonna really focus on that as well. So the first one is protein, having protein as a building block in our meal. The second is fat, again, an important macronutrient. The third is carbohydrates. Those are our three main macronutrients. And the fourth one, I want you to think about vegetables, because produce is so good for you. So as we are building a meal, if we're looking at a plate and we've got those four components, that is going to be nourishing and it's going to be balanced. And especially when we're adding that veggies in, we're gonna be getting fiber, which is so good for the body. Okay, my third tip for you is to snack smart. Now, oftentimes, you got the meals down. Breakfast, lunch, and dinner. You're like, I'm doing great. The thing that is challenging me and my family is the snacking. Okay, so this is maybe tough love, but I want you to just absorb it and see how it feels. So think about what you're bringing into the house. If you're constantly wishing that you or your spouse or your kids were not eating certain foods, try to not bring them in the house. They won't be eating them if they're not there. Now, if you have older kiddos that, you know, can drive and go to the store themselves, that can be trickier. But if you've got little kiddos like me, they're only choosing foods that are around in the kitchen. The other day, my oldest Hunter, he was walking around the kitchen looking for a snack. I saw him open up the pantry and he was just looking. And then he opened up the fridge and pulled out an apple and got a cutting board and cut himself apple. And I was like, oh, you're just making my mom heart so happy as you looked through and decided on an apple. And you know, if we had something else that was just overly processed and made for him to crave it, likely he would have chosen that, because that's just what happens with those kind of foods. Okay, my last and fourth tip for you guys to, again, be more healthy and happy and less healthy and stressed is to meal plan. Now, meal planning on its own takes stress out of the feeding your family equation. We've already spent one day, maybe 30 minutes, planning out the meals so that we don't have to think about it come breakfast, lunch, and dinner, day after day after day. I mean, you think about it, that's a lot of decisions in a week just about food. And I know that you have a lot of decisions that you gotta make. I know I do. And so if I can just take one of them out, I know that's really helpful for me. And so I want that for you too. So if you're like, yes, I want a meal plan, Heather, then come back next week, because I'm gonna teach you my meal planning strategies. I can't wait for you to be there. So a quick recap of our four tips. One, focus on real foods. Second is to build your balanced plates. Your third is to snack smartly, focusing on those whole foods in your snacks. And then number four is to meal plan. So be sure to come back next week and I'm gonna teach you all my tricks, tips, to keep you happy and healthy as well. Be sure to subscribe to my channel so that you don't miss it out. And if you enjoyed this video, thumbs up, leave a comment down below and let me know if it was helpful for you or if you have any questions. I am here to help and answer. All right, I'll see you later.